young mycologists in South and North America and we're very close and very tight, and we collaborate a lot looking for solutions and working really hard to translate science to common language for policy reasons or just for outreach. So I feel there's a very, very powerful generation of scientists and just fungal advocates that are working together. It's extremely important, and especially for the fungi, because without fungi, there is no ecosystem. Fungi are the organisms that connect plants to animals, animals to bacteria, plants to bacteria, and that create this pulsating, you know, intertwined and interconnected being that we call an ecosystem. Fungi have demonstrated that no life form lives individually. And so when you lose the fungi, there are the organisms that connect them, you're basically disintegrating a body that can't live without these limbs, any part of the limb.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gru Vandergrift from the University of Oregon. I specialize in the genus Xylaria. We've used the study of Xylaria as endophytes and as decomposers to elucidate a really interesting ecological theory called the foraging ascomycete theory. The most fulfilling, the most rewarding part of my work has been the way that it has dovetailed with conservation efforts. So I did my dissertation and have worked for years at a place called Reserva Los Cedros in Ecuador. A couple years ago, this protected forest came under threat of mining. I recently testified before the Constitutional Court of Ecuador about how mining could have severely deleterious effects on the biodiversity and the ecosystem services that this important protected forest provides. In fact, at the moment, I'm actually producing a documentary film, and I hope as I move forward that I will continue to be able to use scientific advocacy and scientific communication as tools in my conservation toolkit to help protect the vulnerable and voiceless species of the world.
There is a very big interest in the nature-based solutions that are held within the kingdom of the fungi, or queendom of the fungi.
The recent advances that we've made with genomics and how that's allowing us to interrogate fungal genomes and especially biosynthetic gene clusters in new ways. And I think that we're gonna see some really cool discoveries made in the next 10, 20 years, because we can mine whole genomes now for those biosynthetic gene clusters and then express them in heterologous systems like yeast and discover what kinds of compounds, bioactive compounds, which might have profound therapeutic properties, these fungi are making, because they're not always easy to observe directly in the whole organism, but being able to take this new technology and then put it into a system that we can manipulate more easily to identify these compounds is, I think, potentially going to be a revolutionary approach to discovering new medicines.